In chapter 84 of The Count of Monte Cristo, Vifon investigates the murder of Caderousse while the police search for Benedetto. 3 weeks pass with no luck. Meanwhile, plans are moving forward for the marriage of Andrea Cavalcanti and Eugenie Danglars. Danglars ignores the repulsion Eugenie displays toward marriage in general, and Andrea himself in particular. Meanwhile, the 3 weeks Albert gave Beauchamp until their duel are nearly up. Beauchamp has gone to Greece to discover the facts about Albert's father for himself, and the news is bad. Beauchamp shows Albert documents that prove his father was a traitor, committing treasonous acts for profit. Albert is devastated, and for the sake of their friendship, Beauchamp destroys the documents and promises never to speak of them. Still, he warns Albert that the person responsible for the original newspaper article might have an agenda, and may be intent on revealing the whole story. Albert is grief-stricken over the loss of respect for his father. Beauchamp suggests that they visit the Count of Monte Cristo to take his mind off things. The Count is just such a great confidant. In chapter 85 of The Count of Monte Cristo, the Count is completing paperwork related to Andrea Cavalcanti's marriage to Eugenie Danglars. He assures Albert and Beauchamp that he has not in any way sponsored Andrea, either in society or in the marriage, because he really knows very little about the young man. Noticing Albert's lousy mood, the Count suggests that they both come with him on a trip to the sea. Beauchamp has just returned from the sea and must stay in Paris, but Albert agrees to go. Beauchamp takes his leave, and the conversation turns to Albert's mother. The Count wonders how she feels about him, and Albert replies that she's captivated by him and talks of little else. Albert goes home to prepare for the trip, and the Count tells Bertuccio to inform the relays along the road to Normandy to be ready for two travelers. After a long 8-hour journey, Albert and the Count arrive at the Count's house in Normandy. They spend the next few days hunting and fishing. On the third evening, Albert's valet arrives on horseback. He shows Albert a newspaper article that reveals his father's treachery. A shaken Albert immediately sets out for Paris on horseback.